Hello you all. This is the tutorial that goes along with the pattern for the underwear for the 13.5 inch doll. Okay, so the materials needed are on the pattern, but I will show you anyway. I have cut two pieces of the pants with just a little bit of seam allowance, because you are going to work with the overlocker. But if you don't have an overlocker, then please do cut enough seam allowance for your normal sewing machine. And in the middle, up above, sorry, is coming folded over elastic. Now, if you don't use folded over elastic and you want to use normal elastic in a case, then you have to cut somewhat more, of course. Okay, so be careful and watch out that you do that. The same counts for the legs. I use folded over elastic. If you're not and you want a case in which you can do some elastic, then you have to cut the case extra. Hope that's clear. And then I've cut the shirt. I have to think about it, because it's a tank top or a shirt. Okay, it is the, for, let's call it the shirt. And you've cut two exactly the same pieces. And the one shoulder is higher up than the other shoulder, and it will become clear when once we assemble the pattern why that is. Then I have two straps of elastic, which I'm going to use for the legs. You can use folded over elastic. In this case, I wanted to use some decorative elastic. It's up to you. I have some folded over elastic for the waist. And I've cut it at the right size. I've just measured around my doll. I think that's the best way to go, because every doll is different. And I know that this is the right side for that doll. And then I am complete, I guess. Yes. I thought, what is this? This is another piece of folded over elastic. But it's the piece that I cut off. Here, here. Okay, now let's assemble the pattern. First of all, I'm going to start with the shirt, with the tank top. Or however it's called. I remove my pattern piece and I'm first going to close the side seams. Now this is the right side of the fabric, so I'm going to fold this over, fold this one over, and lay it on top of each other so the right sides are facing each other. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to close those side seams. And I've got a cover lock, a locker, not a cover lock, an overlocker. But if you don't, you just use your stretch stitch on your normal sewing machine and close the side seams. And then we'll move on. Oh, and you can close your shoulder seam, which is the shorter shoulder. So don't close the longer, close the shorter shoulder. Okay, and then I will be back. So I've closed my side seams and I've closed that shoulder seam, and I've finished the bottom hem, and I just overlocked it, but you could use a zigzag, of course. Now I'm going to apply my lace, and it all depends on what kind of lace you use, or maybe you use a fold over elastic. Look at the material you want to use. Now this material works like this. This is the right side. I've got some lace that needs to be folded over, you see? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place that lace on top of my right side, like this. And then I will put a pin in it just to keep it in place for now. I will stitch that lace in place, sorry, I want to show it as neatly as I can. Okay, so I'm going to stitch that about a quarter of an inch from the edge, and then I can fold this over, and as you can see, that gives a nice clean crisp finish. And I'm going to top stitch. So I will be doing that with a stretch stitch, of course, and then I will be back. So at the next stage of finishing our little top, I have sewn the lace on it, and I've given it a, I'm sorry for the light, it's a bit blown out, but I tried everything and this is what it is. I've given it a nice press, a top stitch, as you can see. Now the only thing left to do is finish off the neckline, this shoulder line, and the armholes. And well, you could use bias bands, but my I don't do it because this is a very tiny shirt, and bias tape is at least 1 centimeter. And that could become a little bit bulky, so I don't like that. I just fold it over, and this is a very difficult thing to do. It's very fiddly. I just fold it over just a couple of millimeters, not more than this, and I finish it off with a wide zigzag or a stretch stitch. I've got a stretch stitch on my machine that's a bit wide. As long as you use a stretch, what a difficult word, a stretch stitch, then you will be just fine. But remember, you do need to take your time for this and finish this off as neatly as you can. So the long shoulders won't be connected to each other. They are going to be finished with this little seam, and then this is the closure of the shirt, so you can put it on upside top down or from the underside up. And this you can finish off with a snap or a little bit of Velcro. I like to use a little bit of Velcro, but it will be clear. So I'm going to finish off those seams, those raw seams, and I'm going to put a little bit of Velcro on the shoulder. And then the shirt is ready, and we're going to move on with the underpants. Okay. Well, the shirt is done. Okay. So, I've closed all this. I finished the seams. And I did something wrong. And I have to tell you, it's better not to close that shoulder seam before finishing your sleeve holes seams, because it was very difficult to get into this tiny hole, and when I didn't close this seam, I had far more space to be finishing off that seam. Okay, so here is the little Velcro, and as you can see, you can put this tank top on from the bottom up and close it on her shoulder. A nice lace detail. So that's finished. Now we can move on with her pants. I will take my pattern off like this. Now, first of all, I'm going to close the mid front seam. I'm going to lay right sides together. And you can see, you can recognize the mid-front seam because it is a little bit shorter than that mid-back seam. This is the mid-back seam. And as you can see, it is a little bit different. This is the mid-front seam. That's the only seam I'm going to close right now before we move on. And I wanted to tell you something, because I know some of you are pretty new to sewing, and it can be difficult to sew in a straight line. Now, what I like to use and what I like to recommend everybody is this magnetic sewing guide. It's very easy. It is very magnetic, and you place it on your sewing machine, on that piece of metal. Let's presume here's your needle, and this is that metal plate. You're going to place it just where there where you want to have it, there where you want to guide your fabric. I think that's clear. So it is a magnetic seam guide. It's not expensive, but very, very useful. Now I'm going to close this seam, and it will be... Now that was easy. It looks like this. Funny, but it looks like this. Now the first thing I'm going to do, because it's so tiny, and I don't want to be working so fiddly, I'm going to place the elastics on the legs and in the waist. So let me start with the waist. For the waist, I told you I will be using a folded over elastic. Folded over elastic looks like this. You can purchase it in very different forms. I like to use this one, and it is a double elastic, but you can fold it open. You see? That's what I like to use, and now you can fold it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to place this in front of me, fold it open, and I'm going to place the back side of the fabric. Here is the good side, the front side, and this is the back side. Okay, and I'm going to place the back side of the fabric on the first half of my folded over elastic. I will show you just in a minute. So what I have now is, this is the good side of the fabric. I placed it on that folded elastic, and I placed the good side over it. So I'm going to sew. First I'm going to sew, of course, this line. And when I've done that, I can fold it over, and I have the right side of that folded elastic on the right side of my fabric. And I'm going to top stitch it. But first, you have to lay... This is the right side of your fabric. You have to lay it on your strip of elastic on the half that is going to be, that half of the elastic that is going to be inside your body. That's going to be the wrong side. And when you fold it over, the right side will be visible. See, this is the nice side that will be visible, and I will top stitch it. I'm going to do that right now, and I hope you do understand, and otherwise you can always ask. So I've stitched it once in the fold, and of course your elastic is somewhat shorter than your fabric, because you need this elasticity. That means that when you are going to sew, I like to place it in front of me, place a pin over here, then stretch the elastic up to where it meets the fabric, and place a pin on half mid front again. Okay, so that way when you have your machine and your needle is in, you can keep it, hold it over here and keep it on each other on the right amount of stretch. Now when you top stitch it, that isn't necessary because you already gave it that elasticity. So I'm just going to fold this over, and I'm going to top stitch it. So that looks to me a very nice finished edge, and a very nice elastic too. So now we are going to finish the elastic on the legs, and I've given the legs a coverlock or overlock. Coverlock, overlock, it's so different, but you can use a tiny zigzag too. It is not necessary if you use that folded elastic for the legs too. Then you don't have to finish that line, of course. But I am going to use some different elastic for the legs. It's this elastic, and it's not folded over or anything, so I need a clean edge. So I finished my legs with the overlock, and now I have to place my piece of elastic. It doesn't have a right or a wrong side. That's easy. I have to place it on top of the right side of my leg, of my pattern piece, of my fabric. I've pinned it in place and I have to stretch it all out to the next corner and stitch this all over. Now remember, stitching elastic fabric or elastic on itself, it needs a stretch stitch. So we're still working with that stretch stitch. I'm going to cover this up with a stretch stitch. Although that's something I could do, but I can see now that it maybe it is even nicer when I just stitch this on that finished edge and leave it as it is. I'm going to do that. I will be right back. Well, that looks nice. It's a nice clean finish. It has enough stretch and it's looking quite well on the inside as well. Okay, now the last thing to do is just close the seam at the mid of the back, mid back, yes. Close that seam. Okay. And then close the seam in between the legs. And then we're finished. So the last video, the final product. And I show you in different forms. Now, there is something I must tell you and I should have told you at the beginning of this video. But nevertheless, I'm going to tell you now. Please measure your doll before you're going to cut the fabric. Because we all stuff our dolls differently. And fabric can have different stretch. I'm going to show you. I made this lovely top together with you. And I tried to put it on and it doesn't fit. Because this is too small. Now this jersey doesn't have much stretch. As this knitted fabric with those tiny little holes has a lot more stretch. So I made two of the same tops. The last one I did together with you doesn't fit, but this one does. And it's exactly the same size. What I mean to say is when you measure the waist of your doll, then you can measure your pattern and if necessary, just make it a little bit wider. That's what I'm trying to say, to avoid disappointments. The pants, that's not much of a problem. They all fit. But especially for the tank top, for this shirt, the width, you do have to measure. Now, then you can have different options. As I told you, this little Pontuel jersey, we made together this one with that lace on the bottom. I made a little pants from that Pontuel jersey too. That's cute. And I used folded over elastic in the waist as well as on the legs. And a little pants from just normal white jersey. It doesn't have that much stretch. And I used light blue folded over elastic on the legs. So there are many, many, many options. The pants that I made together with you, I used this kind of elastic. It works a little bit different, but I guess you can figure it out and listen good to my videos. So we're finished and she has lovely underwear. And I think the next thing she's going to need is a lovely dress. So see you soon.